السلام عليكم ورحمه الله وبركاته. ما اجمل سماع ما عذبه ولدنا لو جلسنا الى الفجر فاستمع اليه على هذا اللقاء. لكن الناس لديها تركيبات.
Assalamu alaikum. How beautiful the dance, the sound of this of the bill of taqwa from the machines was, and we could have stayed listening to it all night and all the way to pleasure. Were it not for the fact that people have things to do and places to go to.
Alhamdulillah.
What praise be to Allah?
Rabbil alamin.
Lord of the world.
والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد المبعوث رحمة للعالمين.
And blessings and peace be upon our master Muhammad, who was sent as a mercy to the world.
More than me.
The manifest light.
الذي كان في الفطار صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه في فجر الأطفال.
Amongst his examples is that he loved children, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
كَانَ إِذَا مَرَّ فِي الطَّرِيقِ وَجَدَ الْأَطْفَالَ يَلْعَبُونَ يُبَادِرُهُمْ هُوَ بِالسَّلَامِ.
He was walking in the street or on the road or on the way, when he saw, when he came upon children, he would be the first to greet them.
وَرُبَّمَا كَانَتِ الْجَارِيَةُ الصَّغِيرَةُ يعني الطفلة الصغيرة فتأخذ بيده لأمر هي تريد فيقوم معها حتى يقضي حاجتها ثم يأخذ.
Chance a little girl would run up to him, grab him by the hand, and pull him along because she wanted him to do something for her, and he would go along with him. Allah Almighty.
مر به أنس رضي الله تعالى عنه وهو يحفو صلى الله عليه وسلم على يديه وركبتيه سيدنا الحسين على ظهره.
One time Anas Ibn Malik رضي الله عنه وقال walked on him صلى الله عليه وسلم and the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was down on his knees crawling on all fours with Sayyidina Hussein on his back.
قام مع أمامة ابنة سيدتنا زينب بنت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم خرج معه لما رأته خارجا إلى المسجد للصلاة. جاءت معه إلى المسجد أمامة أمها سيدتنا زينب بنت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Umama, the Prophet's granddaughter, daughter from his daughter Zainab, went out with him to the mosque, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. She was a very small girl. She just began to walk. So he picked her up and carried her, blessings and peace be upon
him.
And he did the takbir of salah while still carrying her, sallallahu alayhi
wa sallam.
When he went down to sujood, he put her on the ground. When he wanted to go back up to stand, he'd pick her up again.
ومعنى في ذلك من معنى رقيق راقي قال بعض العلماء أيضا فيه لفت للنظر إلى الفرح بالبنات لأن الناس كانت حديثة في عهد الجاهلية وكانت دائما البنات لا تترك بهم.
But the scholars said the things that can be gleaned from them, but one of them is the joy the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم felt for having girls as a family, because this was a society that had freshly come out of Jahiliyyah, and this was a society which where there wasn't that kind of joy sometimes with
people.
One day he was praying with the children, with the people, leading the people in prayer, and he prolonged his prostration, this is a peace be upon
him.
And he kept on prolonging it. And it was not, and he kept, made it long again. And he made his prostration so long that some of the companions began to think that maybe he passed away while still in prostration. And when he finished the prayer, the companion said, "You prolonged your prayer, especially your sujood, for longer than that is usually your custom or your habit." So he pointed to Sayyidina Hussein. He said, because this son of mine was riding on my back while I was in sujood.
من الراحلة.
He said, think of what he said. He said, with the halabi, meaning that he rode on my back, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, so I disliked that I lift my head until he'd had his fill and got off by himself. He was in his part of the pulpit giving a sermon one day. And it was the Friday sermon. Which is made as an obligatory sermon. It's not a public admonishment or a public lecture. And Imam Hassan came into the mosque. He was still a toddler, so he was just beginning to walk, but he walked a few steps and fall over.
فلما راى النبي كاد يسقط يتعثر نزل من على المنبر. ولعل الله أن يصلح لي بين فئتين عظيمتين من المسلمين.
And the chance God will put right the relations between two great groups of the Muslims.
وهنا ملمح إضافة إلى ما اختصت به العتة المطهرة.
And he said that here is something that one should notice on top of noticing the special position that the Prophet's family had hold.
هذا الملمح هو أن الطفل الصغير إذا عمل الاحترام وأشعر بالقيمة وخوطب على أنه صاحب عقل وكرامة
Like it feels important that he's an object of
concern.
That child will grow up with a receptivity or an ability to give, a disposition to give.
And
I'm talking here about concern and looking after the intended to the child. But not to such an excess that it engenders in a child selfishness.
كثير من بيوتنا ألفوا أن يقابلوا أبنائهم عندما يضربون بطريقة فيها تفريغ لما لديهم من غضب ربما من أشياء أخرى غير الطفل الصغير.
So many of us, many of our homes, when someone wants to chastise a child, they chastise them with things that are going on. Other than even what the child has done, it was nothing the child did. But what if the good people were still already carrying things from other questions?
لدي مشاكل في الحياة، في العمل، في أذى، ابتلاء، فيأتي متأثر. مجرد أن يخطئ الطفل الصغير خطأ بسيط، ترى يفرغ كل ما لديه من النظر في هذا الطفل الصغير.
Sometimes pressures from work, pressures from the outside world. So the time the child makes a little mistake. All of that pressure is venting on the child. This isn't educating or bringing up a child. He said, and how many, one caller to faith said, how many of us, our generation, have grown up, been brought up and educated by parents where we didn't hear this long list of insults when someone is chastising us.
Ya Rabbi.
You idiot.
Rafael.
Stupid boy or stupid girl.
Ma.
Donkey.
بين هذا الولد الذي يسمع أنه غبي ومغفل وحمار ماذا تنتظر منه؟
What do you expect of someone, of a child that's grown up and told, you idiot, you're stupid, you're a donkey? And the child's hearing this repeated again and
again.
What do you think that child's going to be like when he grows up? The beloved of God, this is a peace be upon him.
إلا السيدة فاطمة عليه السلام.
lived to bury all of his children except Sayyidina Fatima, and may peace be upon him.
ثم جاءه سيدنا إبراهيم والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم حاضر السكين.
His son was born to him. His son Abraham was born to him when he was nearly 60 years old.
ففرح به صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And he was very happy with صلى الله عليه وسلم.
ثم فوجئ بهم يخبرونه أن إبراهيم مرض.
And then he was surprised to hear that he was told Abraham was sick.
ونصحوا أن يذهب به إلى خارج المدينة إلى ضاحية من ضواحي المدينة في بستان فيه ماء عذب وهواء نقي.
And they advised that he be taken to the outskirts of Medina to a place where there is orchards and good water. And they took him. And his mother was with him. And then he was surprised again to hear when someone said to him, Go to Abraham because his sickness is what even
worse.
And then the Prophet ﷺ went to that orchard.
And
he was brought to him was his son Abraham. So he put him in his staff. And he said that Abraham's chest, the way that his chest was, he was breathing heavily, he was in his last moments. So can you feel what it must be like? His son was born to him after he lost the others at nearly the age of 60. And then he was affronting him now about to leave his life, about to leave his life. And he's carrying him in his hand, resting him on his lap when he's watching him going through this. And his tears, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, began to flow. When he passed away, he said to God, we belong and to him we return. And at your departure, O Abraham, we are saddened. But we'll say nothing except what pleases our Lord. And one of the companions, when he saw him in his state, he said, O Messenger of God, why do you grieve like this and cry when you are someone who they knew that the Prophet ﷺ was someone who was always satisfied with God's
will? المقصود من التساؤل من التعجب كيف تبكي الآن؟
So he would have come and said because you're someone who's always satisfied with what's to be, but that was the implication of what he said. He said you're in a state of sorrow.
فقال له إنها رحمة.
He said it's just it's compassion that makes me cry.
جاء إليه أحد أجلاف العرب اسمه الأقرع بن حابس.
And then one of these harsh Arabs came to him from أقرع بن حابس.
فوجد النبي يقبل سيدنا الحسن.
And he found him kissing his son Hassan, his descendant, his grandson Hassan. He said, did you do that? He said, I've got 10 children and I've never kissed any of
them.
And we said, what can I do for you if God's torn mercy out of compassion out from your heart? Take the compassion out of your heart. Rents of passion out of your heart.
أن ندعو لها وتقول عليها أن يذهب مرة أخرى ويرى هذا المنظر.
He said, so he said back, you say we'll pay for her. because it was a burden for him to go from the bus again to see.
فألحت عليه أنه أرسلت إليه مرة أخرى. تريد منه أن يواسيها.
But his daughter insisted because she wanted him to be that consultant.
ففعل صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And he did this as a priestly appointment.
فجيء له بالطفلة واحتضرت وضيفة حجره الشريف.
And they brought in the child, and the child let out the last breath, all of his life.
لماذا أكلمكم عن هذه المشاعر؟
Why do I tell you about such feelings?
لأن مفهوم المتابعة للجناب النبوي الشريف لا يقتصر على الأداء الجسدي للطاعات.
Because following the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is not limited to just physically doing the acts of worship.
المتابعة للحبيب صلى الله عليه وسلم بالحركات الجسدية كنحو الصلاة أو الامتناع الجسدي كنحو الصيام هذه مهمة وليست فقط منها.
Following the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم based on the physical limbs and doing the prayers and the way he did the other rituals and the way he did them so it's
not to be limited.
But there's another meaning.
للمتابعة
it follows there's another meaning to what it means to
follow.
Many of us when they want to become upright and hold on to their faith overlook this part. It is to follow the Prophet even in his emotions in how he felt. What are the situations where he smiled and laughed?
ما هي المواقف التي بكى
فيها؟ What situations made him cry?
ما هي المواقف التي أظهر تألمه فيها؟
What situations made him express his sorrow?
لما سئل سيدنا حمزة ورآه قد مثل في جسده بكى فقال يا حمزة يا مفرج الكربات.
When he saw Hamza laid up dead, he cried and he said, Oh Hamza, oh the one who relieved so many sorrows.
أيضا من معاني المتابعة وجهة القلوب باليقين.
And also amongst the forms of following the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is that the hearts be orientated to a state of certainty.
لما آوى إلى الغار كما تعلمون ووصل كفار قريش إليه بسبب أنه كان معهم من يقتصر أتى.
He said that when he went into the cave sallallahu alayhi wa sallam while being followed by the Kuffar of Quraysh because they had with them a pathfinder, so someone who could find, who could track someone, a tracker.
بكى سيدنا أبو بكر.
Our master Abu Bakr cried.
قال يا رسول الله.
He said, Oh Messenger of God.
لو نظر أحدهم إلى موضع قدميه لرآه.
If any of them had looked at where his feet were, he would have seen us. If I'm killed, it's just Abu Bakr at that house. He said, but two of you pass away, the whole nation would be lost. But then he smiled, Prophet
smiled.
You know what it is to be able to smile in such a situation, such a grave situation?
كم مرة من المرات نزلت بك مشاكل وأعتقت بك مخاطر وشعرت أن هناك شيء مقبل عليك.
How many times did you feel that some problems come to you or troubles come to you or did you feel a sense of trepidation at something imminent?
في هذه الأيام كثير من المسلمين هنا في هذه البلاد يشعرون بالقلق أليس كذلك؟
Even in these times, even in these days right now, many Muslims feel a state of anxiety. Is that all right?
طيب.
They feel that there's a change in the way people behave in the Muslim. Isn't that right?
من الدولة ومن الناس.
Both at the same level and at the level of the people. In the
behalf of Islam, Islamophobia.
Islamophobia. There are new laws that could be put into place. There are things that are hurting you.
صحيح.
Yes.
إذا نتعلم منه صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Therefore, let's learn from him صلى الله عليه وسلم. This is almost the meaning of following, to walk in his footsteps on the
water.
He's smart.
وقال يا أبا بكر
سيد الله
ما ظنك باثنين الله ثالثهما
What do you think of two people whom Allah is the third one in their presence?
ثاني اثنين إنهما في الغالب إذ يقول لصاحبه لا تحزن إن الله
The second of a party of two who tells to who says to his friends, Do not grieve, for God is with us.
Who are these, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam?
It was heard, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
قبل أن يهاجر
Before he made his exodus,
ضرب
He was struck.
خنق
He was strangled.
جاء عقبة بن أبي معيط والله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم يصلي في المسجد
صحن الكعبة. Uncle Abba bin Muayyad came to him when he was praying in the forecourt of the sanctuary near the Kaaba.
ولف رداءه على عنقه صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And he took his own mantle and tied it again around the neck of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
شكاه بشدة.
And pulled him.
حتى تهنت ركبته الشريفة وقع على الأرض صلى الله عليه وسلم.
To the point his knees buckled and he fell on the floor صلى الله عليه وسلم.
جاء الأمر وضع على ظهره سلى الوجوه. الوسخ الذي يخرج من الناقة على الولادة.
He said that one time he basically took the embryonic sac from a she camel that had given birth, all of the byproducts of the birth. After she'd given birth, he'd taken it and basically put it on the Prophet's back while the Prophet was in prostration. In the area just around the Kaaba, the space just around the Kaaba. And the Prophet didn't move, sallallahu alayhi wa
sallam.
Until someone gave news of this to his daughter, Fatima Zahra, may God have peace, may peace be upon her. And she was very, she was still a young girl. She was less than 18.
لأني ولدت في السنة الخامسة للبعثة فإذا هذا ستكون في الثامنة من عمرها عليه السلام أو التاسعة
Since she was born in the fifth year after the Prophet's mission, so she must have been about 8.
وقيل الخامسة قبل البعثة على رواية
And there's another narration which says she was born 5 years before the
Prophet.
And she came and she took all of this from his back. Off his back,
sallallahu
I mentioned there was a situation that Fatima, there was a stance that Fatima took.
When the battle
of Uhud ensued, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was struck on the face. To the point that the helmet of the Prophet, he was struck so hard, that the helmet embedded itself on his cheek sallallahu
alayhi wa sallam.
And when they took it off, he started to bleed sallallahu alayhi wa
sallam. كلما مسحوه لا يزال ينزل. جاءت السيدة فاطمة معنا حتى تجفف الدم وتمسح الدم ولم ينزل.
And every time they wipe it, it will bleed again. And so the Fatima came and started using a cloth to wipe it. Well, pat it dry, but the blood must keep coming. فأحرقت
حصير وأخذت الرماد وكبست به الجرح حتى يسكن.
So she took some dried hay, set it alight, and then rubbed the ash on the wound so it dried up. And she was crying. These are emotions. When the mountain angel came to him, sallallahu
alayhi wa sallam,
and his heels was going to go bleeding. And he asked him if he could have the permission of the Prophet to fold up the two mountains on the people of Mecca.
فقال لا فإني أرجو أن يخرج الله من أعقابهم من ينصر هذا الدين.
He said no, because I hope that God will bring forth on the issue forth from their loins, people will give victory to this people.
فجاء من عقب أبي جهل سيدنا عكرمة.
And from the descendants of Abu Jahl, we have our master Akrima.
ومن عقب أمية سيدنا صفوان.
And from the descendants of Umayyah, our master Safwan.
ومن عقب الوليد سيدنا خالد بن الوليد.
And from the descendants of Walid, سيدنا خالد بن صدق الوليد.
فنصر الله به الدين.
So Allah gave victory to the Spain by this gift.
ماذا أريد من هذه الوقائع؟
What do I want to get out of the sight of these situations for you?
أريد أن أستشعر ماذا كان عليه الباطن الشريف.
I want you to feel what the inward of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was experiencing.
كيف نتعامل مع الأذى؟
How we treat when others mistreat us. How we deal with others mistreat us.
الله أخبرنا أننا سنسمع من الذين أخذوا الكتاب من قبلنا أذى كثيرة والذين أشركوا أذى كثيرة. فتسمعون من الذين أخذوا الكتاب من قبلكم والذين أذى كثيرة.
Allah already told us that He's here for the people of the book that came before us and those who ascribe partners to God, much that will hurt you. What's the way to deal with this? God has already told us that if we have, if we're conscious of God and have patience, this was a sign of strength. Because God says it's a sign of someone's strength. How can such a situation be
strengthened?
He said that this, I don't want people to get mixed up here. It doesn't mean just becoming someone who doesn't do anything when someone wrongs him, someone who doesn't take his right, someone who doesn't get his right by law, or go about it in the right, through the right channels. I don't think so. These are just causes. These ways of getting your right are just causes. But what I'm getting at is what state is our heart in what we're doing. He said if others can get to us physically and hurt us physically,
فهل نهزم فنسمح لهم بأن يطالونا بالأذى المعنوي؟
Do we allow ourselves to be told to be defeated so that they harm us inwardly by making us change?
تعرفون الأذى المعنوي؟
So do you know what that inner harm is?
الهزيمة.
It's to be defeated.
أي هزيمة؟
What defeat?
هزيمة القلوب.
It's the defeat of hearts. It's when hearts are defeated.
عندما ينجح من يؤذيك في أن يقتحم قلبك فيملأه بغضاء وحقد وكراهية.
He said when the person who is making you, attacking you, can assail your heart and fill it with rancor, anger and hate.
إذا كنت لا تستطيع في بعض المواقف أن تدفع أذى حسي.
He said if you can't in some situations deflect the physical harm that one does to you, or that you try to do so, deflect it, and work on
it.
Don't make it such that when you're outwardly trying to get your rights, that you allow that person to think that what that person is doing to creep into your heart and defeat you inwardly. That's why we commanded to be patient. While being God fearing, while being conscious of God. Whoever deals with a bad situation with patience and God consciousness, which is something that God has enjoined us in many passages of His revelation. It is amongst the customs of God in creation that He would make that person victorious. These laws of God do not change They're a beautiful horse.
من سنن الله أن الذي يصبر ويتقي يحافظ على قلبه لا بد أن ينفصل.
The person who is patient and has God consciousness and therefore protects his heart will by necessity be victorious. We'll try it.
حولكم أناس مرضى بالكراهية.
There are people who surround you, who are around, there are people around you who are sick because of their hatred. We need to repeat these words. There are people around you who are sick with hate. From the extremists among the Muslims. Those who basically express religiosity as hatred and anger and something repugnant. And then they basically try to express the truth in a way that is unbefitting of his grandeur and his compassion.
I was
told by one of the scholars, he's originally from Mauritania, what they used to call Shenqit. He lives in Dammam, in a part of Saudi Arabia, the eastern part of Saudi Arabia. He said, I was approached by an old American man. And he said to me, while hesitant, I love Islam, I like Islam. I've been working in Aramco, which is one of the oil companies, for 30 years. And I like this faith, and I would like to embrace it. Is this possible? He said, obviously, yes. I'll articulate the two testimonies of faith that you follow me. And the man said, wait for it.
هل أنت متأكد أن يمكنني أن أكون مسلماً؟
Said wait, are you sure I can become Muslim?
قبل الله.
Obviously yes.
ويقبله من الله.
And Allah will accept me.
ويغفر لي.
Forgive me.
هل هذا الإسلام يجب أن أقبله؟
Then the Islam wipes the stain of sin away with the blood of
the أمر استغراب.
And the man was looked at him surprised.
هذا ما قصدك؟ لماذا أنت مستغرب؟
He said, so the scholar said to him, why are you so surprised?
قال قبل ستة أشهر ذهبت إلى المسجد.
So 6 months ago, I went to the imam of a mosque. Said, I wanted to become a Muslim. Will God forgive me? Will God accept and forgive me after all of these years? And accept him. But the imam said to him, no, no. Game's up for you. It's over. He said, I accepted it, but if there was some doubt, how can God not accept me? So I came 6 months later to ask you now, just because soon I'm heading back home to the States. The Sheikh gave him the two testimonies. He told him the things that were necessary for him to know. And then he went to the Imam of the mosque.
قال يا شيخ جاءك أمريكي قبل 6 أشهر يسألك هل يمكن أن يفرق؟ قلت له لا خلاص انتهت
الفرصة. He said, Sheikh, this American came to you 6 months ago and asked you, can I become a Muslim? And he said, no, you can't. Is that true?
قال نعم.
Yes.
قال لماذا؟
He said, why?
قال هذا 60 سنة يتمتع بالحريم والمعاصي والخمر بعدين يريد يدخل الجنة معنا؟
He said, look, that man's 60 years old now. He's been womanizing all these years, drinking, having it up, having his pleasures, enjoying himself, and now he wants to come in the garden with us. Sick. Firstly, he's blocked someone from reaching God. And this is a huge, great sin. He said, there's something else. Did anyone notice? opponent.
هل انتبهت لها؟ ما هي الخطيئة الثانية في كلامك؟
What's the second problem with this? What's the second mistake in the words of Sam? The Bati said he's going to enter the garden with us. So this Imam has already guaranteed himself the garden. He's in. Another third thing
though. أنه عاش حياته وهو ينظر إلى المعاصي على أنها مقتضى.
Is that Imam has lived his whole life, seeing all these sins and worldly pleasures as something that one coveted.
وينظر إلى الطاعة على أنها حرمان.
And he was looking at the obedience he was living as if it was being barred from actually enjoying life.
حول مع الناس من هذا النوع يريدون أن يملكوا الآخرين.
There are people who are like this amongst us.
يريدون أن يهلكوا كل من يختلف معهم.
They want to destroy anyone who differs from them.
ما رأيت واحد في التلفاز يدعو على من يخالفونه على من يخالف الطوائف الأخرى.
He said I want someone of them on the television making a supplication against those who differ from him.
مفترض أن شيخ.
And he's supposed to be a sheikh.
صدمت من الكلام الذي يقوله.
I was shocked at the words he was saying.
يدعو الله يقول الله ما أصبهم بالسرطان.
He said are you praying to God saying God may you afflict them with cancer. May you make their blood clot up and freeze in their veins. Overcome them by all manners of epidemics and plagues. Destroy their children and wives. What's this? The problem is this man is articulating his words and he thinks he's actually talking, he's addressing God with this. He said the one who is being oppressed, it is not permitted for him to exceed in his when he supplicates against the person. So if he can't find it in his heart to forgive, and chooses to make a supplication against the person who wronged him, he's not allowed to exceed even in what he says. And the problem is that these brothers of ours think by doing all of this, they're actually helping the faith. This faith cannot be helped except by being upon what the Prophet was on. His heart wasn't thus.
صلوا على الحبيب
هو الذي بعد الشفاعة العظمى وبعد الدخول إلى الجنة ينظر فيرى بعض من أمته في النار.
It is he who would look after his supplicated God and interceded for them in the day of judgment and see that some of his nation is still in hell.
من الذين أضاعوا أنفسهم جنوا على أنفسهم ظلموا أنفسهم.
You see some of his nation is still in the inferno and it would be those who've left nothing undone, everything reprehensible they've done. And the Prophet ﷺ will prostrate, cast himself down in prostration before the Divine Throne. And God will say to him, lift your head and ask, intercede in your beginnings. A group of my nation is in hell, but in the final of my Lord. And it's the Prophet is asking for these people who are probably the criminals, the immorally depraved, who are in the inferno, but it's like the garden will not. He will not find peace, but find comfort in the garden until his entire nation is, and his entire people is all
right.
So the garden is in a place of solace for him until they're all right. So God will say to him, go and take out of the garden anyone who has such and such a portion of faith.
يخرجون ويدخلون الجنة فينظر فيرى أناس إيمانهم أقل من هذا.
then the Prophet would take them out and they're going to the garden and he'd look into the inferno and see there's people still there who have a little less faith than that. And he'd go down the prostration again. So the Prophet would be kept ticked on being told, lift your head, ask him, and you need to intercede, and you'll be given a decision. So the people in my community have less faith in this, O my Lord. He said, so God will say to him, and finally, go in there and take out anyone who even has an atom's weight of faith from the fire. So they all so they get taken out. And then he looks and there's still people there, so he go down and prostration again. And he's been told, oh Muhammad, raise your head, ask, you'll be for it, and intercede and you'll be given. Oh my Lord, there are still people there whose faith is less than an atom's weight of faith. Can you feel the shame, the sense of shame the Prophet feels that he's asking the God that there are people in his nation and community who don't even have an atom's weight of faith, and he's having to ask for them. Let's not put him to shame, make him feel ashamed of asking. But don't do this. He doesn't deserve this response. He's given us much. 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 And God will say to him, go there and take out of the garden, go take out of the inferno, anyone who has even less than a mustard seed of faith in them. So they get taken out. There is still a remnant of people who haven't even got that much. And he put down the frustration before the throne. Raise your head, ask, and you'll be given. And you will intercede, and you'll be given. The Prophet would say there are still amongst our community people in the inferno whose faith hasn't even reached less than a mustard seed of faith. And he'll say, oh Muhammad. His Lord will say to him, for what he sees of his compassion for his community. And God loves, people say that God loves all things. His creation, his servants, those who are compassionate. Oh Muhammad, go and take out of it. Who said, anyone who's ever said, La ilaha illallah, there's no divinity other than Allah, save from his heart even once. So then you release. Look at the vast difference between the person who said, I don't want this American to come in heaven with us. And how the Prophet was sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the Prophet's perception. I know we're being hurt. We're treated differently and racism in many instances. He said, when we see this in the East and the West, the most people who are being persecuted and having their bloodshed are our community. We become a plaything in the hands of the lords of war, people who sell weapons. But how have they managed to assail us in this way? Because they've assailed our interior, our inward being.
على ماذا من في بيت بيوتنا تصبح وتبصي على الآية؟
When you wake up and you go to sleep, what do you wake up and go to sleep to?
ما حال ذكر في بيوتنا؟
How much remembrance do you make in our houses?
البيت الذي يقرأ فيه القرآن بقراءة لأهل السماء كما تقرأ النجوم لأهل الأرض. بيتك هكذا؟
He said, the house in which the Quran is being recited is seen by me in the angelic world, in the heavenly kingdom, as brilliant and as dazzling as a star is seen by people in the
earth.
What are our regular devotions of seeking, of invoking, asking Allah for forgiveness or salutations of the Prophet? How much time do we spend studying the description of the Prophet, his shama'il, or his biographies? The states of his heart, the emotions he experienced. But we, rather we have Muslims who are sick with hate. But we have amongst the other Muslims people who are sick with hate. We have lobbies, we have far rights, and we have these games, election games being played out. No? We see, we experience the hurts that God mentioned in the Quran. Because there are people who live in the earth who believe that they're the only ones worthy of living and others are less than them. How can we deal with the two parties? Far out extremists and our extremists. It's important. This is part of what it means to follow the Prophet
Muhammad.
He said, following the Prophet isn't limited to growing a beard, having hijab, wearing a turban. These things are important, but can't limit following him to that. Follow him in our hearts, and our hearts aligned with his heart. But how much do we think and reflect on what's going on in our hearts, and how much it's in line with what's in his heart? How did he ever look at someone who was sick with hate? Was he hateful when he looked at someone who was sick? How did he treat someone who was sick? There's Tubaha who was walking behind him, having already determined that he was going to try and assassinate the Prophet. See the dagger in his garment. He was circling the Kaaba with the Prophet after the Prophet had taken the Prophet Mecca. He had the same sickness, hate. He said he found it too much that the Prophet had taken Mecca and that the Prophet, what the Prophet was calling to, was going to be prevalent. It wasn't even enough for him that the Prophet said, go on, you're all free, to those who've done everything. He wasn't even moved by the Prophet's forgiveness and pardon. A heart full with rancor and hate. And the Prophet stood while doing his circling of the Kaaba, turned to him. The Prophet's custom was when he turned with his whole being, he turned his whole body. And he said, Fudala, what are you saying to yourself? He said, the remembrance of Allah, Messenger of
Allah.
So he smiled and went off, kept walking. And the man,
Fudala,
he said, so he started following the Prophet, thinking, as soon as I had an opportunity, I'm going to stab him. So he was going to commit the most serious crime in existence. And the Prophet stopped this and peace be upon him. He turned his whole being towards him. He said, oh, Fudala, what are you telling yourself? سيد الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الله ورسوله الله الله في الله
تمشى صلى الله عليه وسلم
and the prophet carried a walk in the city of Israel
وهو يمشي وعلى ذلك الفرصة لكن ما شيء هزل من سامة
He said that when he was following the prophet, he was trying to look for an opportunity, but something inside him had already been shaken by the prophet's mind. So something in him, there was a fight, an inner struggle inside him, an inner struggle between his anger, his rancor and hate, and the character he just been so short. You know why? Because the person who has a lot of hate is weak. No matter how much power he tries to display to
him,
he is someone who is defeated inside. The Prophet walked verses of peace be upon him and then he stopped. He turned his totality towards the man and his smile. And he said, Fulala, what are you talking to? What are you saying to yourself?
أذكر الله.
I'm remembering God.
تبسم صلى الله عليه وسلم ومد يده الشريفة ووضعها على صدر
الله. And the Prophet smiled and he stretched out his blessed hand and put it on Fulala's chest.
مد يده الرحمة إلى الصدر الذي يخبئ السكينة التي يريد أن يضعها.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم extended the hand of compassion onto the chest which was concealed in the dagger. That was intended to kill him.
يقول فضالة.
فضالة said,
لقد وضع يده على صدره.
He put his hand on my chest.
وليس على وجه الأرض أحد أبغض إلي منه.
And on the face of the earth there was not someone I hated more than him.
شفتوا كراهية.
Look at how much hate.
قال والله فوالله ما وقع على وجه الأرض أحب إلي منه.
He said, I swear by God, I may take his hand off my chest, except there is no one on earth more beloved to me than him. Who is the one in power? Who is the one who has strength? And who is the one who is feeble? Which one do you want to be? You want to walk in his footsteps?
Hard?
Yes, hard.
نعم
صعب. But it is hard.
هذا دليل على أنها قوة، لأن لو كانت ضعف لكانت سهلة.
That's an indication that it is more it is the stronger thing to be, because if it was not, it would be easy to do.
لكن هلنا من الذي أن ندعو نقول اللهم إنك إذا شئت جعلت الحزن سهلا.
He said that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم told us to supplicate. He said one of his supplications was he said, Oh Allah, when you will it, you make an impassable valley, you make an impassable area full of boulders and jagged rocks into a plain. And I'm not telling you about not working, not putting things right, outwardly not correcting things, not putting things in their proper place. Again, I'm not asking you not to take the right channels, not to take the right causes, not to correct things, not to put things right. My words here aren't about what you do outwardly. You're supposed to act. What I'm talking about here is the hearts that have been changed. When you need to deal with things and you see these people who are sick around you, take the prophetic medicine. Prophetic medicine is to confront them with compassion. No matter how much they keep on telling you the same message, No matter how hard you try, it never be enough. Carry on. Because as he intensifies, and the moment he tries to intensify the game.
هذه زيادة تليق على أنه اهتز في بعضها.
To make you feel that don't keep trying. That intensification from him is already an indication that something in him has been shaken.
من أين جاء هذا الكلام؟
When did I get this one?
قال ربي.
My Lord says.
ادفع بالتي هي أحسن.
Reflect that which is better.
فإذا الذي بينك وبينه عداوة كأنه ولي الحميد.
So that he with whom you have an animosity becomes like a beloved friend.
تأمل قوله كأنه لم يقل سيكون وليا حميما.
He didn't say it is a, he said he, it was as if he is a beloved friend. He didn't say he will become a beloved friend.
لأن بعض الناس
مهما تعاملت
معهم بالإحسان صعب عليهم
أن يحبوك. For some people, no matter how much you offer them, it'd be difficult for them to love.
لكن سيشعرون بهزة تجعلهم يتعاملون معك بميل إلى المودة.
But some people will be shaken and they will treat you like someone who's a little bit inclined to.
وربي سبحانه وتعالى قال بعد ذلك ما يلقاها إلا من المصدر.
The God says after that, and no one will be able to receive this except those who are patient. And no one will receive it except the one whose portion is fortunate.
صبروا. مرة ثانية ولكن نقول صبر التقوى. صبروا وحب من التوفيق.
So firstly, they were patient, and that is this immense divine enablement of that.
الخلاصة.
In summary.
قد تستقبلكم أيام صعبة.
You may be going through the difficult case.
قد.
You may go through the difficult case.
لكن من وراء قد احتمال قد تستقبلكم أيام صعبة.
You may you may have hard days.
احتمال.
It's a possibility.
لكن.
But.
أحوال قلوبكم.
The states of your heart.
وراء. اقتداءكم بالحديث صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And you're following his example صلى الله عليه وسلم.
سيجعل هذه الأيام الصعبة تتحول إلى أيام سعادة.
We'll make these hard days turn into days of joy.
ونصرة.
A victory.
وطمأنينة.
And tranquility.
وتمكن من الخير.
And for good to be established.
ويأتي بناء على ذلك الوقت الذين حواليكم يشعرون أنهم بحاجة إلى الذي في قلوبهم.
And based upon that, those around you will start seeing that they need whatever is in your heart.
صدقوني أهل الكراهية هؤلاء أرحم منهم.
Believe me, people who hate, their souls are actually tired. They're weary.
متعب.
They're weary inside.
لهذا.
Their spirits are weary.
ثقوا بالصبر والتقوى مهما مرت عليكم الأيام صعبة ستخرج بحال أفضل مما تتصورون.
So therefore, be confident and being patient and being God-conscious. You'll come out of this with more than you expected. If you make yourself stronger than those people. Stronger in here. Don't let anyone defeat you in your hearts. Let none of them assail your hearts with hatred.
أننا أتباع سيدنا محمد.
Teach them that we're the followers of our Master Muhammad.
أروهم كيف يكون أهل المحبة لسيدنا محمد.
Show them how people of God and the Prophet are.
هم محتاجين لله.
They need it.
صدقوني هم محتاجين لله.
Believe me, they need it.
وسترون عجبا.
And you'll see wonders.
نسأل الله أن يرزقنا الثبات على متابعته صلى الله عليه وسلم.
May our soul to give us steadfastness in following
Him.
In our inwards and in our outwards and our inwards.
Allahumma inna qulubana tad'i hubbaka wa hubba sayyidina Muhammadin.
O God, our hearts make a claim that we love you and we love our Master Muhammad.
Wa anta mutali'un ala daqa'iqi khataya.
And you are aware of the minute things that are concealed therein. And if you find we're being honest in our claim, then honesty is something you love. Increase us in it. And make us amongst the
people.
And let us experience love. Let us experience the light of love and let us become absent in the light of
love.
And let us get intoxicated with the goblet of love. And if you find in our hearts nothing but empty claims and sick souls, let this claim of something have a truth in it.
اللهم
اجعل قلوبنا محبة لك ولسيدنا محمد صلى
الله عليه وسلم. واجعل هذه المحبة أحب إلينا من أنفسنا وأهلنا وذرياتنا من الماء البارد في شدة الظلام.
And let this love be more beloved to us than ourselves and our families and children and a cool draught of water in a parching heat.
اللهم املأ بواطننا بها.
Allah fill our hearts with this. And let the springs of mercy gush forth in our hearts. So that we can quench souls that have become parched with hatred and rancor.
اللهم احفظ أمة سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم في هذا البلد.
Allah protect the nation, the community of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in this time.
Allahumma
la quluba
nuran.
Oh Allah, fill their hearts with His light.
Wabahjatan wa surura.
With light and joy.
Allahumma kullahum bima kunta bihi lil mahbubin min ibadik.
Allah be for them what you are for the beloveds of your servants.
Wa akrimhum bi sharifi rashadika wa sir azim imdadik.
And give them the honor of your guidance and your great support. Protect them from ill harm and every enemy and all and anything that befalls them.
Allahumma inna nasta'inuka ikhwatana fi hadha al-balad.
Oh Allah, we put our brothers in these lands in your care.
Nastawfiruka iyyahum.
And we consign them to your care.
Fahfazhum.
So protect them.
واحفظ عليهم دينهم.
And protect their faith in them.
ورقي إيمانهم.
And raise their faith.
يا خير مستودع.
Oh, He who is the best custodian.
يا رحمن الدنيا والآخرة.
Oh, merciful. Oh, He who is merciful in this world and the next.
اللهم بارك هذا البلد.
Oh, Allah bless this land.
وابسط فيها بسط النور.
And spread in it the lights of guidance.
والهداية.
The spread in it lights and darkness.
والخير.
And good.
واشمل من فيها مسلما كان او غير مسلم بانوار الرضا منك والهدايه.
And envelop every one of the people of this land, be they Muslim or non-Muslim, with your pleasure and your guidance.
اللهم من كان مريض القلب بالضرار فانا نسالك لنا وله طهاره القلب.
Oh Allah, whoever's heart is sick with rancor and hate, we ask you for us and them to remedy the malady. Oh Allah, alleviate the suffering of the Ummah of
Muhammad.
Oh Allah, have mercy on the community. Oh Allah, guide the community of
Muhammad.
Oh Allah, give triumph to the nation.
Oh
Allah, Allah take hold of the nation of
Sayyidina.
Oh Allah, return the community of our Master Muhammad to the way of our Master Muhammad in a beautiful way. Oh Allah, lift from this community the cane of chastisement. Oh Allah, treat us and them with your subtle graces, oh you who has subtle graces. Oh the most generous. In honor of the Rabb of our Master Muhammad, blessed be the
Prophet.
As a nobleman to Sayyidina Muhammad. In order to let joy into the heart of our Master. Alleviate the suffering of this community.
Ya Rabb, فرج عن أمة الإجابة وفرج عن أمة الدعوة سائر الخلق.
Oh Allah, alleviate the suffering of those of His community, His nation, who already follow Him, and those of His nation who have been called to Him, which is the whole of
Christ.
Oh, most noble, oh, most generous of generous. Oh Allah, bless our brothers who were served to make this possible. And give us the provision of sincerity. Oh Allah, whoever has a need in this gathering, Allah please fulfill it. And clean up the recesses of our hearts of anything in them that is not befitting of your gaze upon
us.
Allah, cure us. And alleviate the person amongst us from our and give success and ennoblement, enablement to those who have life. And mercy to the dead. Almost merciful. And let the last words that we say in this world be
La ilaha والسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين الفاتحة. السلام عليكم.